The time filtered function is a very handy feature that will allow you to look at the amount of time where an expression is true. One of the most common uses for the time filtered function is simply calculating collective runtime of a piece of equipment. I've got a tag called CDM158, and this tag is a digital tag, and it is reflecting the position of a switch. And I'm going to consider every time this tag has a value of auto or the tag has a value of manual, I consider that machine to be running. And in this case, I have typed the expression out, CDM158 equals auto, and the tag name in single quotes, the string in double quotes. And I've inserted an OR, and then CDM158 equals manual. So I will count the amount of time that this expression is true, so I will be counting both of those states. And I'm going to use a start time of 4 days ago and an end time of today. You can go back as far as you have data. I'll use the time filtered function, and the expression I want to evaluate for is in that cell. The start time is T minus 4 days, and the end time is today. And you have an option of showing the results in seconds, minutes, hours, or days. I want to show minutes, and I am just going to further break this down into 1 day intervals. And so I want to see on a day-by-day basis how many minutes this machine's been running. And if I do the calculation, you can see that the machine was not running on the 10th of September. However, in the following days, it was running to certain degrees, and you can sum this up and do a total number there. And I've just very easily done a runtime report for the last 4 days for this particular machine. It's been running 601.7 minutes.